Hey, good afternoon, everyone. As you all know, Matrix X is going to be launching tomorrow morning. So to make sure you are as prepared as possible, we have brought on the best of the best, Jay Myers from CoreLogic. Jay, take it away.
Thanks, Rochelle, and good day, everyone. Glad to join you virtually this year, hopefully in person next year. We want to prepare you for what's coming with Matrix X, and then also give you a little sneak peek of what's coming a little bit further down the road to make sure that you have that level of excitement about Matrix and all the features that it brings to you as your tool in your business. So without further ado, we want to make sure that we continue to listen to people when we make design changes and decisions in Matrix, and we do that off of user feedback. Not only we hear that from our direct customer care reps, but we also pick up that feedback from focus groups and user group meetings. So rest assured, your feelings about how we should work with Matrix moving forward are being heard. We want to continue always delivering the best user experience, in other words, how you do things, and the best user interface, what you see, updates. We've also gone and put some usability best practices in place as we introduce those new features and components of Matrix. We do some organizing, some consolidating and simplifying, which you'll see today in Matrix, and we'll continue to work with that same method of madness, if you will, moving forward. And we also are laying the groundwork for a modern, responsive design of the Matrix system. So with that being said, let's go ahead and just jump right into it and let you see what's happening with Matrix X. So some of the changes might be a little more subtle than others. Some may be a little more, bold, if you will. But let's just talk with, first of all, the user interface. The top of the Matrix navigation bar has some consolidation and organizational features that have been implemented. We've taken away a lot of the excess clicks across the top and organize them into some more logical places. And one of the things that we did was we took away the settings area, which you used to find under My Matrix. It's no longer there. It is now under the new utility menu, which is located in the top right-hand corner of your page. In mine, it says, Hello, Jay. When I click there, that's where I'm now going to find the settings that I used to find under My Matrix. Just a more consolidated, better organized, best practice way of doing things. We've also placed the help, mobile, and logout options underneath your name. So if you're looking for something in the normal navigation and you can't find it, just move over to this new utility menu in the top right and you should see it there. As an example, with the settings area, which, by the way, you may notice is a new look and feel. We started out with that module because it was easy to do. The settings module now takes up the entire width of your browser, so it doesn't, be left justified on the left-hand side of your screen, hard to read. We've used icons now throughout the system to have better visibility into what some of these tools do, so you'll start to see that modernization as we continue to refine Matrix moving forward. So settings is going to be the first part that changes. The good news is once you click on any one of these options, it works the same way that it's always done before. Another place that we did some user interface changes to is under the contact area. So when you go to My Matrix and go to contacts, you'll notice that that part also is now expanding the full width of the browser. Again, want to make sure that we're making things as large and as visible and as easy to use no matter what device you're on. So this is a different look, but it's the same feel. We moved everything pretty much to the top of the page. So just poke around here when you get a chance and you'll see everything that you're familiar with is still there. It just may be in a more logical place, if you will. And then when you start getting into the details of a particular contact record and you click on his or her name, you're going to notice that's going to change also. Again, taking up the full width of the browser, no longer that accordion style opening and closing way of getting to information. Now, if I'm looking at the details of an individual contact record, we use that tabular way of doing things, just like we do on the matrix search results page when you're looking at a listing and going through the listing and the tax and the flood and things like that. It's kind of that same type of way of moving around. Here's the details, the auto emails, any properties you may have in a cart tied to this individual, any sent emails and whether or not they viewed that, and also searches that you have tied to them, including the results and the settings criteria, just like you have before. So other than a visual change, which is more modern and a better workflow, everything else is going to remain exactly the same. So you know how to see the results of a search, you can still click there and see them like you always did before. And this whole piece right here under the contact record and back over here under the settings area is setting us up for a responsive design matrix program. And you can see here the settings area would scale nicely on your mobile phone. So again, working towards that in each and every iteration of Matrix moving forward. The next module that we are working on to have the whole modernization piece is the search module, which we all use a lot. So look for that coming during the first part of next year. Again, doing it in slow, gradual changes. Get used to one. We'll give you another one to work with moving forward. A couple of things we did inside Matrix for you. One of the things that is a small thing, and you may not have even noticed it before, is we've added a refresh option to the My Listings widget. We do have that under the Market Watch today. We added that a while back. Refresh is exactly that. It refreshes the content that you see under My Listings to always make sure that you have the most current up-to-the-second information, whether it's your listings or listings within your office or your firm. So refresh just gives it a kick in the pants, if you will, and refreshes the information so you will always be up to date. Always, always, always. You know, things change fast, but we want to make sure that you see them. Not that it didn't refresh before, it just didn't do it in real time. It took maybe 15 minutes. So sometimes you think something was there and you are wondering where it is. Now just click refresh and there is no doubt at that point. As far as another item that we've changed on the Matrix screen is the speed bar. The speed bar is that bar right below the top navigation and above all of the widgets. The speed bar is now much larger. It's easier to see and hopefully easier to use on a tablet or a smaller device. The speed bar, of course, is where you can do simple searches. You can look up folks, you can look up offices and things like that. If you don't know what the speed bar is or curious, click on the question mark and review the help information that pops up. That tells you all about the speed bar and how to use it. Another piece that we've changed is in the search results. Actually, a couple of things changed here. Number one, you'll notice that we've modernized some of the tabs. The criteria map and results tab now have new modern looking symbols, if you will. Same with the managed displays and set and clear defaults. So you'll see some modernization throughout Matrix there. Again, bringing it up to the 21st century, not of 1982. You may also notice on the search results screen that we've added a couple of what we call sort order indicators. You've always been able to sort each column by clicking on the column header. You've been able to rearrange the columns and adjust the columns. And of course, remember that you can always add columns here too. That functionality is still there and has not gone away. But there are folks that like to organize data, in other words, search results, and they want to do it, you know, as a way where they can look at something and then something within something and then something within something, right? So kind of like if you're working in Excel or you're working in numbers where you can do multi-level sorts, you'll notice that in my case here, there is a bold arrow indicator under the area. Then if I move over to the furnished column, there is a semi-transparent arrow. And then if I move over to the price, there is a non-transparent arrow. What those simply mean is the bold arrow is the primary sort that is being done in this result grid. So I know that my area is the primary sort searching alphabetically in ascending order. In other words, starts in Beaufort County, Belfair, Berkeley, Bluffton, and so on and so forth. So in ascending order. My secondary sort is furnished, yes, no, within those particular areas. So primary, secondary. And then the third or tertiary sort is my price. So within those areas, whether or not it's furnished or not, and then the price will be grouped together there. Very similar to the experience you see again in Excel or numbers, if you're familiar with that. Matrix has always been able to do multi-column sorts. If you go to refine on the button bar, click the sort option, you will see here, area, furnished, and list price. Those are where my three arrows are. Now I can add more fields and continue to sort to my heart's content, but only the top three will have arrows that appear on the screen. So you can change that if you want it to work the way you want it to work. And then you can always set that as a default if you would like to go to that level. That's a little more of an advanced function, but for the folks that would like those advanced functions and always want to be able to quickly and easily see how things are being sorted and organized, the new sort order indicators are going to be something that will be beneficial to you. Another thing that we did inside of Matrix, which you may or may not know, is when you have a long list of properties, and I've got 153 here, and I've got 100 per page because I can set my page limit and set that as a default. I've got a long list here, and if I'm somewhere in the middle, let's say I'm at number 51 here, and I want to take a look at that particular property just because it catches my eye, and I click on the listing number, it takes me to that agent full report, as you would expect. Now, if I want to go back to my list again, I can very easily do that by clicking my agent line item display. But what happens now is Matrix will remember where you left off. So in other words, the scrolling remembers where you left off. It doesn't drop you back at the top of the page or the bottom of the page like it used to before. It remembers where you left off. And what we do with that is we call that a single line display that remembers the vertical scroll position. So just know if you go from a single line to a property and back to the single line, it drops you back off where you were. Simple, but hey, it's effective. Stops the scrolling up and down, if you will. The tooltips. What are tooltips? Those are those little icons you see over on the left and on the right and pretty much all over Matrix for viewing photos or viewing maps or viewing virtual tours or things like that. You may or may not have noticed before that if you hovered over one of those intentionally or accidentally, that the order of the coloring was reversed. There was black lettering with a white background, which made it hard to see sometimes. So we just inverted the colors, black background, white text, easier to see, easier to read. It's the little things that make the difference, if you will. Speaking of little things, the maps. We've now added the map to display the entire width of your browser. I don't know if you realize it or not, but go back and look today before we do this upgrade late tonight. Go back today and pull up a map, and you'll notice that about a third of the page on the right-hand side is white. It has nothing on it. It's either a scratch pad or future development or whatever you want to call it. The map never took the entire width of the browser. So now we've expanded that so it's easier to see, right? We want to utilize as much real estate as we can for the map. So that will now expand the entire width of the browser as you see here. Again, it's something that you may have wondered why we didn't do that. Well, now we have done that for you. Another option that we added in on the map, we've been taken the little icons here and also modernized them for your drawing tools as you would expect. But the layers that you see, we've always had those boundaries, we've had those parcel characteristics, those trends, those points of interest. But now as an added bonus, we've also added MLS status layers. So now when you're looking at a map, maybe you have a particular search that you ran and you pull up a couple of properties, but you're interested, you know, I was looking for actives, but what's sold around this area in the past 12 months? I can now layer on the sold properties in this area in the past 12 months, regardless of the search that I did. Maybe I want to see all of the active properties, have nothing to do with my original search, but I want to get a real nice holistic look at the area here. And you can see the active properties in addition to my search results, along with any recent sold properties in red. And we always, always can click on a marker and go directly to that property that has not changed. In addition to adding on the MLS statuses, you can also put the tax data on, and you can also put the distressed properties on. So if there's any, you know, short sales in the area, you can go and add those on if that is the case. So a better, more holistic look at an area on a map with all MLS statuses applied to see, you know, popular, is it their activity out there, especially if you're doing a comparative market analysis, right? Maybe you want to see what your competition is or what competition could be there or has been there in the past. So the map now expands the entire width of the browser, and you have some additional map layers to work with from there. The other thing that we've done, which may be something that would be of interest to you, is for those folks that use the auto emails in Matrix, where you go set up a search and you tie it to one of your clients and you have the Matrix program go out and search for you automatically and then send results to your client. Some of you know there's a concierge mode where you can do that same thing, but have those listings come to you first to be able to be vetted out. And we've had this nice little widget here called the concierge widget that you can click on and you can go take a look at those properties that were searched for by Matrix and found by Matrix for you to review. We also, in the top left-hand corner above the news and alerts, used to have a little indicator that said concierge alert, right? Very hard to see, was not a best practice. So now to alert you to those concierge properties waiting for your approval, we've added an icon in the top right-hand corner of the page to the left of your name, that little bell with a number next to it. You ever seen that before? Yeah, probably. Look at your phone. It's probably a missed call you got or a text you haven't answered yet or one of a multitude of apps that you haven't updated yet, right? That little number next to that bell in Matrix is alerting you to the fact that there are concierge notifications that are waiting for your approval. It's what we call a best practice. If you click there, you will then see the notifications that are waiting your approval. And when you click there, you will then be able to go through and approve or reject those properties that Matrix found for you. So just a little bit of a better call to action for you with that notification. And then while I'm here, one additional feature that we've added is there is now a map tab on the concierge results page. There was not before. So if you were trying to, you know, see where all of these properties are, you know, spatially on a map, you couldn't do that. You had to look at everyone individually. It didn't follow the rest of Matrix. So we have the results tab, and now we have a map tab, so we can see where all of those properties are located. It's just being consistent with what you expect when you are running searches inside of Matrix. And speaking of running searches inside of Matrix, on your map, one additional feature that we've added here is if you're looking in a particular area, and I'll just come down here a little bit, and maybe you're drawing something on the map. You're drawing something, let's say, a pretty big draw here. We'll do this. And then we're also putting a shape, let's say, over here. And notice that some of those properties overlap between those two shapes. Now, you can say, I only want to see the properties where the two shapes overlap. So those are the intersections only. So if I hover over any one of the red dots and say include intersection only, it's only going to provide, in this case, the one property that applies for both search shapes. That way, if you've got two people looking for two totally different areas, but the two areas just happen to overlap a little bit, hey, you can make everybody happy and say, I found you something that you like in your world, and I found you something that you like in your world also. You can undo that and then have everything back if you want to. And as always, you can exclude shapes. That's something that we have always had inside of Matrix. So those are a couple of the user interface changes in Matrix. and a couple of the user experience changes that we've added into Matrix with Matrix X. But we're not done yet. There's more. There's more coming. Let me talk about some more that's coming right here. Some more stuff that's coming in Ad Edit, which is if you add or edit listings and you're putting the property in and our magic geocoder can't seem to find the property that you're looking for, or it's not 100% sure, it's going to give you a little warning here that should be your due diligence that says, hey, I can't find this property. Please make sure that you confirm everything is correct and place the pin properly. We all know that, you know, the worst thing that can happen is you list a property and somebody pulls it up on the map and it's, well, in the middle of the ocean, right? We don't want that to happen unless, of course, you know, it's an island. Another thing that we've done on the search page, which you didn't see yet, this is something we have to turn on tomorrow, is there'll be a select all and a select none option for your statuses. Simple, but you know, anything to save a couple clicks is good. CMAs, your quick CMA has an old dated look and feel. That's going to be modernized to add in some of those new modern icons across the top of the page. Again, bringing it out of 1982 and bring it to the 21st century, as you can see here. In addition to the quick CMA, not starting tomorrow, but in the very near future, we'll also be redesigning the pages in our CMA wizard. You will see some modern updated pages. The old is on the left, the new is on the right. All again, utilizing the entire page, using more colors, using different fonts, using different icons. Once again, we just, you know, have to do a little bit of cleanup work here, not changing the way things work, just changing the way things look. Because people tell us, hey, you know what? We like the way it works. We just need you to change the way it looks a little bit. So some of these things you'll see here, there'll be very subtle changes. Again, adding some coloring here on the reports, making them, again, more modern, changing charts and graphs to have a little more value and pop to them, if you will, as I continue and move through these individual pages here. So those things are just around the corner. And then a little bit further around the corner is a new modern consumer portal that we're going to be rolling out to replace the current Matrix client portal. Some benefits that it will have is, number one, it'll be fully mobile. It'll take in the web content design elements, which means it'll be as close to ADA compliant as we can make it. It'll contain things like enhanced filters for searching for the consumer, a planner for the consumer to answer some of those questions he or she may have in the journey. And then also something we call a property fit score, where a consumer answers some questions and we tie a number to that property to show how well that property matches up with the consumer's wants and needs that he or she puts in the new portal. We've also added some engagement tools for the consumer, like a mortgage calculator where he or she can go through and get some numbers to get the true numbers with, you know, property taxes and utilities and homeowners fees, not just principal and interest. Bike, transit, and walk scores for the neighborhood, enhanced mapping integration with more boundaries for the consumer, and better looking displays that a consumer is going to see. Speaking of see, how about a sneak peek of all that? I knew you'd want one. So here's the new email templates that'll be brought forward in the near future. Don't have a date yet for you, so don't hold me to dates. This has been rolled out in a couple of places already, so it's not vaporware. We actually have it in process up in Charlotte, North Carolina, up in Cleveland, Akron, Ohio, and out in Colorado Springs, and coming soon to a couple of other places. So enhanced, more modern email templates for a consumer, which then leads them into a new redesigned consumer portal, which we call One Home, which again looks really great on a mobile device. It's fully mobile responsive design for a consumer. That's what they expect and that's what they deserve from you. Enhanced mapping with points of interest and boundaries. Also, more information for the consumer that they don't have to take this address, copy and paste it in one of those other national portals out there, and I'm not going to name names, but they do that because they do provide more information many times. But we're trying to level that up a little bit. We're not trying to, you know, be a public portal. This is a true agent to consumer invite as an agent, you'll still send the direct email or the auto email to the consumer, which then they will open up and see this information. Big, robust pictures with captioning that appears for the consumer. Tools like the estimated monthly cost calculator that they will be able to access here. Things like you're familiar with the collaboration with the note feature that's out there today, all the notes will carry over. Being able to quickly ping an agent and request a tour, give them a little heads up inside of the application versus, you know, going out and texting or emailing them. Being able to see the neighborhood, giving them some insights about the neighborhood. All these tools are made to keep the consumer on the portal that you provide to them and not have the need to go somewhere else on the internet, which we know it's hard for sometimes to bring them back, right? Features, property details, all that information that they are looking for is available here, including the public records information that they can see without having to go somewhere else. We don't name the owner name here, by the way. We just give information about the location, the characteristics, and the tax. We have that rating feature like we do today. All those ratings carry over. Additional map functionality, even down into the parcel level. And then neighborhood lifestyles, walking, biking, transit. Does it fit my lifestyle of today or does it fit my lifestyle of the future? Nearby schools and school districts with their ratings, price and tax history for the consumer to view. And then always keeping them engaged with additional properties that if that one didn't fit, this one might fit a little bit better. Including the property fit score, which a consumer goes in and creates under their preferences by asking just to answering just a few simple questions, which then ties a score to that property, which in theory should make that property go faster because it meets more of their wants and needs. Searchability by the consumer, no problem. They can do that today in Matrix. They can do that in the new portal of the future. So nothing changes there. All of the searches that are currently in the portal today, whether those are auto emails, consumer searches, all of those carry over. We also incorporate a planner, which I mentioned earlier, helping a buyer get through that journey, helping him or her answer some of those simple questions that may be perplexing to them, always knowing that the agent is the center of the transaction at all times. And then finally, tying this back into Matrix by going back into the contact record, as you see today, except then we tie everything right back into one home. Agents have visibility into the progress of the planner. Agents have visibility into the property fit. Agents have visibility into the recent activity. So it's just a different screen that's below, but all of that ties directly into the new one home portal. So that's what's coming. Look forward to that. The Matrix X enhancements happen tomorrow. The new CMA pages happen a little bit further down the road. And then the new One Home portal, which I'm showing you, it should be rolling out for you sometime in the early part of next year. So all good stuff happening with Matrix and all things Matrix related. And that's what I've got for you. I'm going to turn it back over to Rochelle, and we wish y'all a great day.